Mariska Hargitay is a household name and has had a long-standing role as Olivia Benson on the popular show Law & Order SVU. She's had a long and seemingly successful career in addition to running her nonprofit organization, Joyful Heart Foundation. Glamour magazine even recently honored her with a Woman of the Year award. So why are some people saying Mariska Hargitay needs to quit Law & Order? Keep watching to find out. First, why Mariska Hargitay was nominated for Woman of the Year. Mariska Hargitay has been playing the role of Olivia Benson on Law & Order SVU since 1999. The show is the longest-running live-action series on television and has one of the highest numbers of episodes of any TV series, with over 500 to date. Along with her co-star, Christopher Maloney, the duo were one of America's favorite TV couples to watch. Mariska has won an Emmy for her part on Law & Order SVU for Outstanding Lead Actress in a Drama Series. In order to prepare for her role of Olivia Benson, Mariska trained as a rape crisis advocate, and this is what may have led her to begin working as a sexual assault advocate for the organization she started, Joyful Heart Foundation. It is no doubt these accolades that led Glamour magazine to nominate her for their Woman of the Year award, even featuring her on the cover of the Woman of the Year issue of the magazine. But some people don't think Mariska Hargitay is a Woman of the Year at all. In fact, they are calling for her to leave the show that launched her long and prolific career. Next, why critics think Law & Order SVU is misrepresenting the police force. Law & Order SVU stars Mariska Hargitay as a detective and commanding officer of the Special Victims Unit of the New York City Police Department. Some episodes are based on real-life crimes that have been in the media. The show shows the NYPD Special Victims Unit as they investigate crimes revolving around sexual assault or the abuse of children, the disabled, and the elderly. It also portrays Olivia Benson and the police department working in tandem with the Manhattan District Attorney's Office to prosecute the criminals. Many victims of real-life sexual assault crimes imagine when they go to the police that they will have an experience much like what they have seen on TV. But critics of the show and Mariska's role are saying that Law & Order SVU is pro-police propaganda. They say it is falsely building up the reputation of the NYPD, an organization that has allegedly mishandled their division that deals with the cases of sexual assault that are depicted on the show. Victims have reported that the NYPD discourages victims from pressing charges and getting results in their cases, that they do not collect or do not properly submit DNA evidence, and often don't take any action towards the perpetrators of the crimes, which has resulted in some cases in additional attacks. Some victims have even reported being taunted when they went into the police station, a far cry from what is shown on the show. Critics say that the disparity between the show and real life makes it harder to call for improvement within the police force, as people who have not had to directly deal with them assume the organization operates as on TV, which is reportedly not the case. Anti-violence and sexual assault program workers say that the NYPD is notorious for ignoring victims. The NYPD solved less than 30% of the rape cases in all of NYC in the year 2020. Critics of the show say that the positive portrayal of the NYPD on television as helpful and hardworking is working against the cause to improve conditions for survivors of sexual assault. These critics maintain that the police force has a problem that needs to be addressed, and that Mariska Hargitay should quit the show in order to truly support the cause. The actress, who makes approximately $500,000 per episode, is seen to be the face of the SVU brand by critics, and they believe her absence would detract from the show. But what about her charitable organization, Joyful Heart Foundation? Mariska's foundation raises money to assist with the backlog of untested rape kits in police departments in the United States. These rape kits contain DNA that needs to be sent to a lab for testing in order to be used as evidence evidence in sexual assault cases. The actress even went in front of a government committee to discuss the backlog on the kits. However, critics say that the reason police don't send these kits out to be tested is not due to lack of funding or real backlog, but oversight, and the fact that police are simply not sending the kits in to be tested. They view Marishka's Foundation as more of a PR function than a true advocacy organization because they say the problem around rape kits is not with the lack of funding, but with the lack of accountability for the NYPD. However, Marishka says that her job on the show is deeply rewarding to her personally and that fans frequently write to her and approach her to tell her that the show changed their lives or encourage them to report their own sexual assault to the police in their area. Then, Marishka has been contemplating quitting for a different reason. The actress herself has been talking about quitting Law & Order SVU, but for a very different reason that is more personal than political. In fact, she's actually said that the only way she would quit the show is if she knew for sure that it would continue on without her. So it sounds like Marishka is actually very supportive of Law & Order and believes it serves an important purpose. Why has she been thinking about quitting the show that launched her career? Well, in July, the actress broke her knee, tore a ligament, and fractured her ankle in a mysterious accident. She endured a lengthy recovery while filming the show. The injury made her realize she is getting older, as it was difficult for her to play a police officer chasing criminals while she was recovering. The actress has previously suffered injuries while doing her own stunts for the show, including developing a collapsed lung during a fall that left her needing surgery in 2009. Despite the severity of her injury, she was back at work on the set within just one day. Marishka, who is 57 years old, is currently signed on through one more season of Law & Order SVU, so it is unlikely she'll quit right away, as her management team likely does not want her to break her contract. However, it seems like the years are catching up with her, so it's possible if she ends up needing some downtime that the production could pivot her character's story and have her on the show for a lesser number of episodes. The actress has always signed back onto the show season by season, most likely for negotiating purposes. She could always decide to stay on should the show decide to renew again following season 24. We'll just have to wait to find out. So, how will Law & Order SVU end? If Law & Order SVU ends following the 24th season, there are a number of ways the writers could wrap things up. Many fans would like to see Olivia Benson and her partner Stabler get together by the end of the show. Marishka herself has said she would like to see the series end with her character finding peace and balance and love. However, the creator of the show, Dick Wolf, actually named Olivia Benson and Elliot Stabler after his two children. Some fans have speculated that this is the reason why the two characters cannot be together. The show often reflects on real-world happenings, incorporating things like the Black Lives Matter movement and the coronavirus pandemic. NBC also added strict guidelines that the cast and crew must follow in order to cooperate with COVID regulations for returning to work. Season 23 will be running through May of 2022, so a lot could happen before then with the cast and characters who are currently on the show, as well as new faces. We may see more friends and family of the current cast, as this is one show that has a long history of inviting the current cast's relatives on as minor and major characters. In the past, we've seen Marishka Hargitay's dad, Ice-T's wife, and Marishka Hargitay's husband, who actually came to the set for a guest visit and ended up appearing on the show over 30 times total as the character Trevor Langdon, an NYC defense attorney. So is Law & Order SVU ending anytime soon? Well, NBC renewed Law & Order SVU for an additional 3 seasons in February of 2020, so we'll have to wait until renewal time to find out if the network will decide to end the show or maybe pivot and take it in another direction if Marishka Hargitay decides to retire. Do you think it's fair for Marishka to be held accountable for her role on the show SVU as an actress? Let us know in the comments below. And as always, thank you for watching.